quoting Olivia Rodrigo lyrics to end still NXT champion and a blockbuster debut. All that and more as we review last night's NXT and look forward to what next week's huge triple threat main event is going to be. Welcome to a brand new episode of Can We Talk Wrestling, and we are starting. Their match at NXT TakeOver WrestleMania weekend. I think it was called NXT TakeOver Tampa Bay. I don't know. But that TakeOver match was really, really good. So I was excited to see what they were going to do for two, and they knocked it out of the park. The fact that this was on free TV is absolutely, like, damn NXT, that you really want those ratings. So this match was really, really good. It took good back and forth, and Cross won with Balor passing out. So technically, I believe both times Balor really, I forgot if the first time like that happened too, where Balor like passed out and really didn't get pinned or submitted. I'm sure someone in the comments is gonna correct me on that. But this was a really good match. It makes Cross look really dominant heading into whatever match he's gonna have at NXT TakeOver in your house. And it really questions you, is Balor really going to move up to the main roster, which I think is the best thing for him. I think now that, I would say him go to SmackDown, don't go to Raw, but I feel like him going to the main roster is probably the best bet for him, just because it gives him more people to wrestle, because I feel like if you look at the NXT roster, even though there's a whole new crop of talent coming in, I feel like he's basically wrestled everyone on the roster, and has done really everything in NXT that you can do, except win the tag titles and a North American championship, but like all major things, you know, main event takeovers, he's a two-time NXT champion, so I would say for him to go to main roster again, I'm probably gonna, you know, don't go to the main roster, it's gonna ruin him, we saw that the first time. Look at the improvement, kind of. So that's why I argue he should go to the main roster. But speaking of NXT in your house, next week's main event is a triple threat match. It's a triple threat match between Johnny Gargano, Pete Dunne, and Kyle O'Reilly to determine Cross's number one contender. This is going to be a really good match. All three men are super, super talented, and there's a lot of different styles within this because, you know, Kyle's kind of more technical, and Pete is also like a ground wrestler, where Johnny is really a high flyer and very fast paced. So the match would be really good. I think Kyle should win. I think it makes sense to continue the momentum for him because he did beat Adam at NXT TakeOver Tampa. I'm just going to call it Tampa Bay. even though technically it wasn't in Tampa, it was in Orlando, but it's just that's what it's going to be called. So I really hope Kyle wins. I think Kyle and Cross are going to have a really good match too. Obviously, I'm not saying for Kyle to win right away, but I think that's the way to go when thinking of this match, but I'm very excited and good job. And also next week too, I believe it's MSK versus Legado del Fantasma for the tag titles. So lots of things to look forward to for next week. But also speaking of Legado del Fantasma, so Bronson Reed, New North American champion, so excited for him. And he was cutting a promo about how he's worked 14 years and he's finally gotten to the top. He's so excited, he's so proud, and can't wait to defend the title. And Santana's Escobar comes out and he goes, you know, when I think of North America, I think of Mexico and the United States. And one of the, I don't know which one it was, but one of the other guys on Legado del Fantasma was just like, what about Canada? And Santos was like, we talked about this. Canada doesn't count. So it looks like Santos is going to be Bronson's first feud, which is really interesting because I feel like, you know, it does kind of make sense for it to be Santos, but he really just lost two matches. So I don't get what momentum we have to go against Bronson. I mean, not saying that you should do the rematch right away with Johnny, but I was thinking maybe you could put Pete Dunne in there. So if Pete Dunne, like if Kyle's going to be pin Johnny next week, and you could have Bronson and Pete go for the title, I thought that kind of made more sense, since Pete's just saying that no one can beat him right now, and he's like the best NXT superstar in history, which I don't disagree with. So I'm excited for this, but like I said, I just feel like it doesn't make sense logical-wise, because Santos really has no momentum, except that he's a really good superstar and he's super talented. But other than that, like, he's lost. You're supposed to get championship matches after you win. But speaking of the way, we gotta talk about Index. So last week, Candace and Indy were like going for massages, and Dexter was massaging Indy, and she was trashing Dexter. And then when Candace went to pay, obviously it was revealed that Candace was the one sending those chocolate, like, the chocolate and flowers were sent from Candace to for everyone to think it was from Dexter, for Indy to forget about Dexter. So now Indy's looking for Dexter. She gets put in this room, and there's, like, all drawings, and it's, like, heartbreak, and, like, Dexter with, like, a knife in his heart. And WWE NXT Twitter account, oof. So, first of all, if you have not listened to Olivia Rodrigo's new album, Sour, please listen to it. It's actually in my ear right now. So, listen to it. It's actually really good. And from, like, me, who's more of an alternative pop-punk type of person, there's songs from me on this album, so make sure you listen to that. But, basically, WWE NXT Twitter account literally tweeted the picture of Indy and lyrics from Favorite Crime. And everyone was like, oh my god, not WWE NXT, like, Olivia Rodrigo? Whoa. So that was really funny, really exciting. And Izzy and I had a whole conversation about Olivia Rodrigo, so keep your eyes out for that. But I just want Index to be together. I'm so sad. Like, what are you doing, Hunter? But obviously the payoff's going to be that Indy's going to leave the way and go to Dexter. Obviously, I'm not saying right now because Candace and Indy are both the NXT Women's Tag Team Champions. So I don't know when necessarily that's going to happen. Maybe in your house. Maybe, I don't know what the next takeover would be. So look out for that too, I guess, because I'm assuming that's Endgame. I wouldn't see Endgame being like nothing happening from this, and Indy and Dexter just go, because then what's the payoff? And Beth on commentary for this was great, because Beth was like, I can't believe this is happening. But the other thing we have to talk about is Frankie Monet's debut, also known as Taya Valkyrie. She debuted last night against Cora Jade, who also, the commentators were like, oh my god, she signed earlier this year. And I'm like, god, she signed when Taya signed. What? So this match was really good. Frankie Monet just looks super strong in this, and just John Morrison tweeting live on Twitter during this was also really funny too, so we'll go look at those tweets. But this match was really good. Obviously Frankie gets the win. I'm really excited to see what she does in NXT because she is super talented. If you have not seen her work in Impact or the Indies, Lucha Libre, AAA, wherever. But I'm excited to see what she can do. I think she's going to be the one to take the title off Raquel. Obviously, I'm not saying for it to be at In Your House, because I'm going to assume that Dakota is going to turn on Raquel soon. Or, no, Raquel's going to turn on Dakota. Raquel's going to turn on Dakota, and that's probably going to be the match I see take over In Your House. But, I don't know. So, that's pretty much all key points. I mean, Million Dollar Man is now managing LA Knight, I guess. So that's pretty much all the key points of NXT. So make sure to like this video, comment what you guys thought about NXT, the good, the bad, the ugly, and everything in between. Comment what you guys think are going to be some of the matches NXT TakeOver In Your House, because that's in 3 weeks. Make sure to click that bell for notifications and subscribe. And since there's no Dynamite tonight, tomorrow you are going to see my Double or Nothing predictions. So make sure you look out for that video tomorrow, and I'll see you all then.